Yeah, look at me. Yeah. Okay, so. How would you describe the campus climate at UCLA?
I know that we installed solar panels on top of Ackerman. Huh?
Do you know the phrase campus climate? Like, it's like a phrase that we used to talk about, like, general student relationships at UCLA. Like,
oh.
Yeah.
Hello, my name is Heather Rosen, and I am USAC president. Welcome to our new campaign called Inclusivity 101. Don't be an a-hole. The purpose of this initiative is to show us that our words and actions can directly affect others. A lot of us think we know everything. I mean, we are one of the top universities in the world, but we don't. We have no clue about the many experiences that all of us have had. We sometimes make assumptions based on the way someone looks, how someone practices their religion, how someone dresses, the way they speak, but in reality, until we actually get to know someone on a personal level, we will never really know who they are, how they think, or what they are as a person.
But like, I feel comfortable doing
it. All right, everyone quiet. Silent on the set.
A bunch of different groups of people who are all interacting and having peaceful dialogue and sharing different parts of their cultures with one another.
It exists beyond just race and color. It goes to age, sex, gender, religion.
There's a lot of intersectionality that is lacking here.
Having understanding for one another and trying to learn about one another.
I don't know, I think everyone who used that word is trying to say something else. When, like, Chancellor Block says diversity, he's saying, like, look how great we are, look at our brochures. When students here talk about how there isn't enough diversity, they're saying that their groups aren't represented here on campus.
Have people been looking into the camera?
No, they've been
My voice seems to be getting along pretty well. I don't really think there's particularly like one group that's really biased against another group.
Oftentimes I do like pick up a vibe of like it being very cutthroat and like you're on your own.
A lot of communities that feel like they're marginalized and don't feel like they have a voice.
There's a lot of racism, a lot of anti-Semitism, a lot of different forms of discrimination here. And we just continually see it over and over again, and I feel like it's just a perpetual cycle of really bad things happening to different groups.
In that diverse community, there's not that much interaction.
I don't see groups that are underrepresented here as having any incentive to maintain a good campus climate because the status quo isn't working for them.
I would say I have definitely felt unsafe and marginalized at UCLA. It's kind of like having maybe like to adapt to everyone else.
Yeah.
I don't feel like it's the most diverse campus, or in the sense that I think people tend to group together.
Just in general, there's a lot of education.
While in college, we have the opportunity to branch from our own group or community to learn about others, but we instead willingly choose to stay within our comfort zones or our own groups. Intergroup dialogue is absolutely pivotal at a large, diverse university because it allows us to understand others' perspectives.
One of the coolest things about our school is the fact that when there is a problem, we can actually talk about it and we can recognize the fact that that's a problem.
My identity, I'm a proud Jewish girl from America, and I think because of that, I've been motivated to speak to people and educate people about the realities of what my peers have been affected by, and it motivates me to talk to more different types of people from myself.
I would say my identity kind of keeps me within certain groups. You know, I don't venture out to meet like other people.
Oftentimes, when I'm in class, I realize like how many people are of my skin tone, or how many people look like me, how many people are from my hometown, from my city.
For me, you know, I'm an out-of-state student from a very low-income background. I have to miss class to go to work to be able to pay for those classes to begin with. Sometimes we can get so muddled down by stereotypes.
I identify myself as a Persian Jewish man, so I'm like tiptoeing around this line, and depending on who I'm with and the groups of people I'm with, I see my identity change.
Societal and cultural norms and personal histories fit into our own versions of thought, and until we take the time to learn about someone, we cannot expect to understand their perspective. There will be times in which we disagree, but by understanding someone's story, we can better challenge a person's ideas opposed to the person themselves.
Just interacting with one another, more focus on self. It can be like a negative environment for people who are alone.
Well, how do I fit into the different cracks and the different areas within the other culture so that we can all communicate and effectively be equally collaborative?
With different people, I would say sometimes you almost censor like your response to certain questions depending on who you're talking to.
There is a sense of discomfort when you're talking to people different from you just because of the preconceived notions that have existed on this campus.
People's identities here are very politicized in terms of if you belong to a certain group that you definitely believe a certain thing, even though it's probably not true at all.
I think it's a great school, and I think there are a lot of opportunities to mingle if you put yourself out there. Opportunity.
You just treat people like people. Nothing else should matter.
I just say the biggest thing is just respecting one another. I mean, common things that you learn when you're little, like the golden rule, treat others how you want to be treated.
But I'm a firm believer in getting outside of your comfort zone to grow the most as a person, to learn the most you can.
Only together, collectively, can we make a culture change, one of inclusivity and respect, opposed to one of exclusion and disrespect. So remember, don't be an asshole.
Cool. Trying to be deep and big.
No, you know, good word.
Hey, give me put my number in your phone.
Yeah. I'm like, hey, put my number in your phone.
What if I giggle in the middle? Will you cut that out?
Yes. Okay. Or maybe not if it's cute.
Okay. You good?
Yep.
Okay. Wait, are you lying?